I work in Long Pittsburgh. Today, a lot of groups, faith, and labor, and community organizations got together to make sure that people know about the current voter ID law, requiring people in Pennsylvania this year for the first time to carry a photo ID if you want to go vote. There's a lot of people in Pennsylvania, hundreds of thousands of people that don't have an ID. They get information and they get proper identification, they're going to be turned away from the polls on election day. So we're all working really hard to make sure that everybody understands the law and has the opportunity to get an ID. Something people don't know is that because you're not, there shouldn't be any poll taxes to vote. So everybody has a right to get an ID free of charge for voting purposes. If you go to a DMV, be able to get that. But they need different proofs of residency and things like that to get your ID. And a lot of times people don't have their birth certificate or social security card. So we're helping to walk them through the process and making sure that everybody has access to the proper identification so nobody gets turned around on election day. And we all get to exercise our rights. One important thing is if you do get to the polls on election day and you don't have your ID, they do have to let you cast a provisional ballot. It's not exactly the same as a regular ballot, but it gives you an opportunity to go and prove yourself. So everybody, no matter what happens between now and election day, you got to turn out and vote. Fight this every way we can. Everybody should. And this whole law is, what it is about is the same things we fought for, as working class people in this country for a long time. So it's the same reason they tried to stop our votes for many Americans in the 1960s. Same reason people, a lot of different folks, women and minorities, didn't have a right to vote whenever this country was founded. And so, and it's the same reason that people, are losing lots of rights that aren't just about voting. And so, this is about standing up and exercising our rights and showing that we still have those rights and still have some power. And so, no matter what you think, no matter who you support, it's really important to get out and show that we have power. We have the opportunity to exercise those rights in this country.
Rich Fitzgerald, Allegheny County Executive. We're here to educate people, to let people know what they need to do to be eligible to vote this year, whether it be with registration or whether it be with voter ID. So it's something to come out and continue the educational process regarding voting this election.
I'm here with a bunch of people who are trying to get their IDs for voting. They passed the new voter suppression law. We'll need to jump through all kinds of hoops to be able to vote. And the good news is people are willing to do the things to try to overcome the voter suppression that the state has been trying to impose. Representative Mike Terzai said himself that this law was put in place so that Mitt Romney could win Pennsylvania, but sounds like people are fighting back. They're getting registered. They don't want a Romney economy, and they're making sure they're registered. They have the right ID, and they're doing it right now. State by state, they've kind of been picking away at people's right to vote. And what is a post-democracy? So I think there are 6 states now that have the new voter ID laws that are expected to disenfranchise tens of thousands of people.
Okay.
I think it's 9% of the electorate in Pennsylvania might be disenfranchised.
A number of states that have attempted to pass these laws. Recently, the state of Texas passed a law that was overturned in federal court. I know the state of Virginia has looked into this, the state of Florida, and Michigan, and all those other countries. I also believe the state of Indiana is also looking into this. But I believe that there's at least 2 dozen states that have all tried to put this on the books or attempted to put this on the books. What we found in the southern states, states that have a history of voter discrimination going back to the civil rights era, they are under a different jurisdiction through the Department of Justice, through the Voting Rights Act. So most of the southern states that have tried to implement this law, they have been overturned in federal court.
Okay.
Because the Department of Justice has a special jurisdiction in the southern states that has a history of like poll taxes during Jim Crow. But the state of Pennsylvania obviously doesn't fall into that category. So it's going to be a lot harder to deal with this through the Department of Justice, through the federal court system. So we'll see what happens there. Currently it is in the state Supreme Court. They're currently reviewing it. should in the next 2 weeks come out with some sort of judgment on whether this is constitutional or not.
Here today working with our coalition partners to ensure that we preserve democracy. We're very concerned about these voter suppression laws that were introduced in the country, but particularly as we focus on Pennsylvania, the fact that a million people don't have voter ID, particularly people of color, young people, the elderly, and the poor. So today we are here lifting up the fact that people need to get their voter ID, and we as advocates are here to make sure
we have another member of Pittsburgh's own Justice League
getting this done.
We're here State Representative-elect Ed Gainey.
Democracy, and we believe that people have a vote. It is their right.
Good afternoon. How's everybody going?
Anybody.